法老车上的骏马是荣耀的侍奉。
So the horses of the Pharaoh's chariot is a glorious service.
基督看他的这基督看他的信他的门徒的侍奉是荣耀的侍奉。
So Christ sees the service of his believers as a glorious service as well.
你的两腮因发鞭而秀美，你的颈项因珠串而华丽。
And your cheeks are comely with rows of jewels, and neck with chains of gold.
所以这个你就是指着这个骏马。
And so this you is referring to the horses.
指着这个佳偶。
And this a lover.
指着教会。
Referring to the church.
教会因为侍奉而秀美而华丽。
And so the church, because of a service, becomes very beautiful and comely.
所以一个侍奉者，侍奉的人一定是有很好的风范。
And so a person who serves will have very good character.
有很好的样式。
Will have a very good countenance.
美丽的样式。
Beautiful look.
美丽的形象。
And beautiful image.
所以这是，然后我们要为你编上金边镶上银钉。
And we will make thee borders of gold with studs of silver.
我们要为你。
We will make.
所以基督说我们要为你编上金边镶上银钉。
And we will make thee borders of gold with studs of silver.
那么也就是要认可你的工作。
That is approve your work.
编上金边镶上银钉，这是金银宝石的工作。
And gold and silver, the work of gold and silver.
所以新郎对新娘这么说。
And thus said the groom to the bride.
别人看你黑，我们看你极美丽。
People see you as black, but we see you as a beauty.
你不会侍奉，你就要看榜样。然后要学习。
If you don't know how to serve, you must look at examples and learn.
然后呢
？And
要在最纯正的教会里面。来学习
and to learn in a very good and sound church.
要建立，如果建立教会是要建立纯正的教会。
To build a church, build a very orthodox church.
这样的侍奉是很有价值的。
And such a kind of service is very worthwhile.
是金银宝石的工作。
A work of precious stones, gold and silver.
当我这样解的时候呢
？So in explaining this way,
可能你很不安心。
Maybe you feel
心里很不安。
You feel restless.
我刚刚开始的时候，我心里也很不安。
When I first started, I also feel not at ease.
因为这好像是两码事。
Because it seems like another kind of thing.
但是每一次我回到
，But each time,
基督跟教会的这个观点的时候
，Each time we return to the Christ and His Church perspective,
我们就让我们看到基督要看到的教会。是一个怎么样的教会
？And we can see what kind of church does Christ want to see His church.
教会要侍奉神，要是一个怎么样的侍奉
？And for the church to serve God, what kind of church might it be?
好，现在新郎讲完话就轮到新娘了。
And now the bride start to speak again.
我们读十二节。
Look at verse 12.
王正坐席的时候，我的拿达香膏发出香味，我以。我的良人为一袋墨药，藏在我怀中。我以我的良人为一颗奉献花，在隐基底葡萄园中。好，王正在坐席。
But the king is at his table.
我想，王正在坐席的时候，当王正在坐席，这个就是跟王有类似的经历。
What the king sits at the table means having a experience of the inner chambers，
也就是有属灵的交通。
That is spiritual communion。
所以王跟我
，So the king and I，
王正在坐席的时候，他跟我坐席的时候，他跟我有属灵的交通。这完全是一个类似的经历。
The king and I, we sit together at the table. This is the experience of the chambers.
那么我的拿达香膏发出香味。
And therefore, my spikenard will send forth the smell thereof.
拿达香膏是什么呢
？And what is this pure nut of fragrance?
当我们读拿达香膏的时候，我们看到它是用来奉献的。
We look at this a spikenard means that it's something used as an offering.
对，我们看到玛利亚。用拿达香膏来奉献。
You look at how this Mary offered up her this jar of pure nard.
拿达香膏也是一种感恩。
And so to offer up the pure nard is a thanksgiving.
拿达香膏发出香味， 让别人可以嗅到这个香味，这也是一个见证。
And when it sends forth the smell, therefore this nut itself is also a testimony.
所以王正坐席的时候
，So what the king sits at his table.
我有类似的经历
，Having the experience of the chambers.
今天我们跟主的关系，那个类似的经历是很重要的。
And my our relationship with God in the inner chambers is important.
所以我们啊。需要常常有这种内室的经历。
So we must often have this experience of the chambers.
我们借助我们很难定下一个每个人不同的内室经历。
And everybody has different the experience of the chambers.
什么样的经历让你最能够亲近主？
Which experience allows you to draw close to God?
最能够让你奉献，让你感恩，让你作见，让你见证。
That you can thank God, you can give thanks, and you can be a testimony.
那是最好的内室经历了。
And that is the most beautiful and best chambers experience.
所以有内室的经历，就有了这个内室经历所发出来的这个香味。
And with this chambers experience, you have the smell, the fragrance from the chamber, the communion.
然后之后还我以我的良人为一袋末药藏在我怀中。
So a bundle of myrrh is well beloved unto me.
怀中的末药。
And so is within his this bosom.
我们解雅歌的时候，跟有说解别的书，末药常常指作死。
And so we talk about this Song of Songs or other books. Myrrh often refers to death.
墨药代表死
，and represents death.
那么，这个墨药藏在我怀中
，and it shall lie between my bosom.
怀中当然是，是就是心中就是一种的思念。
And it's within you. It's a kind of thinking.
我的心中，我的怀中常常思念这个。莫要在我怀中常常思念主的牺牲。
And so within me, in my heart, often consider the sacrifice of the Lord.
主牺牲的大爱。
The sacrificial love of the Lord.
因为这样的一个思想。
And because of this thinking,
想到主牺牲的大爱，我们才能够让这个拿达香膏发出香味。
Because of the thinking of the great sacrificial love of the Lord, that the smell from the spikenard can be sensed.
所以，当我想起主牺牲的大爱的时候
，So when we think of the great love of sacrifice,
就说了
，And so this he said,
我就能够奉献
，Therefore I can give,
我就能够感恩
，Therefore I can give thanks,
我一定能为主做见证
，I can be a witness, a testimony for the Lord.
然后我以我良人为一颗凤仙花，在隐基底的葡萄园中。
My beloved is unto me as a cluster or campfire in the vineyards of Engedi.
你要解怎么解呢
？How do you explain this campfire？
我以我的良人为一颗凤仙花，你可以，当然可能解法不一样。我们这里说，我以我的良人为一颗凤仙花，就是主的爱。
And we talk about this cluster of campfire, talking about the love of the Lord.
唯有内室的经历
，because of the chamber's experience，
才能够感恩主的爱。
You can give thanks for God's love.
啊，才能够认为主是爱。
You know that the Lord is love.
所以感恩主的爱。
To give thanks for the love of the Lord.
然后享受主的爱。
Enjoy the love of the Lord.
然后思念主的爱。
And to meditate on the love of the Lord.
这是一章。一章十四节
，and chapter 1 verse 14。
好了，然后一章十五节
，1:15。
新郎说话了
，and the groom said，
我的娇，你甚美丽，你甚美丽，你的眼好像鸽子眼。
Behold, thou art fair, my love. Behold, thou art fair. Thou hast dove's eyes.
刚才我说佳偶其实就是一个很尊贵的称呼了。
Love itself is a very dignified address.
既然这个女子是跟主是成双成对的。
This bride, this woman is a couple with the Lord.
是跟主同样的啊，是同样的这样的一个配偶，一个好的配偶，一个好的这个配搭。
It's a very good partner. It's a very good this companion to the Lord.
你甚美丽，你甚美丽。
Oh, you art fair, my love. You art fair.
刚才我们已经说了。
We have said.
教会在主的眼中是极美丽的。
That the church is most beautiful in the eyes of the Lord.
然后，你的眼好像鸽子眼。
And thou hast those eyes.
这是 基督给教会的赞许赞扬。
And this is a praise and commendation that Christ has for his church.
但是这个也是基督对教会的一个要求。
But this is also a requirement that the Lord has for the church.
鸽子眼一般上我们解释它专一。
And when talk about the third size, we talk about this undivided attention.
大家都知道鸽子的记忆很好。
We know that birds has good memory.
所以呢有人用鸽子来送信。
So some people use doves as a messengers.
他以前我读到一课，小学时候读到一个课文啊，一个乡下医生啊，他接到这个病人啊，在家中病的时候，他就把鸽子带出去。
And so I heard, read in primary school.
读的一个读本啊。
I read a book in primary school about how the doctor, a village doctor, found letters from the doves. 然后
医生看病以后就把药方写在纸上，让这个鸽子绑在鸽子的脚里面，让这个鸽子飞回他的家。
So after diagnosing, they put this as prescription into the legs, tie with the legs of the doves and let the doves flew home.
由他的助手配了药，就送到啊，就骑那个自行车就送到这个病人的家。
So when his assistant found it and then mixed with the concord the medicine and
bring
the
person. 他怎么能够记得住呢？
Why did the dust can remember?
说鸽子非常的专一。
It is very this focused.
所以一方面他是赞扬他是鸽子眼。
First of all, he praised him that he has this dust eyes.
但是我想这是神对教会的一个要求。
This is also what the Lord requires of the church.
教会对主应该是专一的。
The church must have this undivided attention to the Lord.
单单的仰望主。
And looking unto the Lord alone.
单单的只是看主。
And just look at the Lord and the Lord
alone. 没有让其他的来分心他对主的那一个爱，主的那个侍奉。
Nothing will this distract him from the love and to serve the Lord.
所以他就这样赞扬他。
So he praised her.
是一个赞扬，也是一个要求。
So it is both a praise and also requirement.
接着新娘就说话了。
And then the bride said.
在第十六节。
Verse 16.
十七节。
And 17.
一起读。我的良人啊，你甚美丽可爱。我们以青草为床榻，以香柏树为房屋的栋梁，以松树为圈子。这个教会说话了，或者新娘说话了。
The church or the bride speaks.
我的良人
，Oh my beloved，
他回应
，She responded，
我的良人是美丽可爱的。
Thou art fair and pleasant。
所以我们今天怎么看基督
？So how do you look at Christ today？
基督是美丽，基督是可爱的。
Christ is fair and pleasant.
然后下面
，and
我们以青草为床榻
，and our bed is green.
来到这里的时候
，I'm up to here.
如果我们以夫妇的关系来解，我们又有很多的遐想了。
And so if we start to explain the husband-wife relationship, we have a lot of thoughts.
我们以基督跟教会来讲
，but we talk about Christ and the church.
我们就知道。当我主跟我们在一起的时候
，We know when the Lord is with us。
我们以青草为床榻
，We have our bed is green。
主可以跟我们在一起的时候，青草为床榻，就代表了安息平安。
And so when the Lord is with us and our bed is in green pastures, we have peace and
rest。青草为床榻，青草也代表供养。供养供应
，and grass, green grass represents nourishment, providence.
床榻也就是躺卧
，and bed is for resting.
所以当主在跟我们在一起的时候
，so when the Lord is with us,
我们得到供养
，we receive providence.
我们得到平安
，we receive peace.
我们得到安息
，we receive this rest.
然后以香柏树为房屋的栋梁
，and the beams of our house are cedar.
不但是青草为床榻。更有香柏树的房屋来，更有房屋是香柏树做栋梁。
And we have this cedar as a rafters of fir.
更有松树做那个圈子，圈子就是屋顶上一根一根的木，然后屋顶就铺在这个木上。
The rafters are the wood to support the roof.
换一句话说
，In other words，
你要怎么解？
How do you explain?
我们一解就是香柏树就是坚固了。
And so cedar is very stable.
然后松木的圈子当然也就是非常的平安。
And the rafters of fir is a very peaceful.
所以当这个教会这么回应说，我的良人啊，你甚美丽可爱。
And so when the church responded, "Oh, my beloved, you are most fair and pleasant." 今天
我们跟主同在的话
，So when we are with the Lord,
我们可以享受平安
，We can enjoy peace.
我们可以得到供养
，We receive nourishment.
我们可以住在那个坚固、那个平安、那个美好的房子里面。
We can stay in a place most very stable and very peaceful.
好，这个就是当我们用基督跟教会。来接雅各的时候，我们得到的这样的一个理解。
So we can understand this when explaining it from the perspective of Christ and the church.
而这里就来到了。
Now we come to.
如果继续讲下去，连这二章一节也是新娘说的。
If chapter 2 verse 1 if continue as the words of the bride.
可是我们觉得。二章一节应该是新郎说的
，But chapter 2 verse 1 ought to be the words of the groom，
因为前面他说我以我良人为一颗奉献花
，Because early on he says that my beloved is like this flower、yeah.。
然后这里如果他新郎讲我是沙伦的玫瑰花，我是谷中的百合花，似乎没什么意义。
And if the bride were to say, "I'm the rose of Sharon, the lily of the valley," has not much meaning.
但是如果由新郎来讲
，But if the groom were to say,
那么就很有意思了。
Then it is very meaningful.
玫瑰花是很普通、很容易找到的。
Of course, you can find rose very easily.
沙伦的玫瑰花
，the rose of Sharon.
百合花代表什么？
And what about lilies?
百合花代表圣洁跟尊贵。
It represents both holiness and dignity.
换一句话说
，In other words,
主是玫瑰花，很普通，就是这位主呢是可以让许多人来亲近。
The Lord is a rose, can be drawn close to by everyone.
很容易让人找到的。
Can be easily found by people.
谷中的百合花。指着他的圣洁跟尊贵。
The lily of the valley refers to its holiness and its dignity.
我们这样解的话，也是有一些诗歌啊，一些帮助我们。
And so in explaining such a way, we also have some hymns to help us.
分心短歌174首怎么说
？And this Johnson Choruses 174 says,
我是沙伦的玫瑰花。
And you are the rose of the Sharon.
我是谷中的百合花。
And the lily of the valleys.
我是园中的奉献花。
And so also the campfire among the forest.
那个分心短歌的174首。
And 174 of these Johnson choruses.
最低限度写这首诗歌的人。
At the very least, the one who wrote this.
他认为。
He felt.
他认为什么
？And what did he feel?
这个玫瑰花跟百合花。是指着基督。
It is a rose. This lily refers to Christ.
前面说主耶稣啊，想起了你。
So, O Lord Jesus, every thought of you.
心中便觉甜蜜。
I felt that it's so good within me.
巴不得今天就被提议跟你同在一起。
Oh, may I be raptured today to be with you.
然后副歌说。
The chorus.
哦，你是园中的丰鲜花。
Oh, you are the campfire in the vineyard.
你是沙伦的玫瑰花。
The rose of Sharon.
你是谷中的百合花。
And the lily of the valley.
使我真舍不下。
That I cannot part with thee.
就是这写这首诗歌的人。
And the one who wrote this hymn.
第一，他以基督跟教会的观点来解雅歌。
First of all, he explained the Song of Songs as Christ and the Church.
第二，来到第二章一节的时候
，When we come to chapter 2 verse 1,
他是用，如果我们照做这个读，便是新娘是沙伦的玫瑰花。
If we read accordingly, this bride is a rose.
新娘是谷中的百合花。
And the bride will be the lily of the valley.
那新郎是奉献花。
And the groom is a blossom or campfire.
写诗歌的人，我们不知道是谁写的。
But we do not know who wrote that hymn.
写分心短歌174首，这位作词跟作曲者。我们的确不知道他是谁。
We do not know who is a writer and a composer. 我
相信是中国教会的一个牧者。
It could be a pastor in the Chinese churches.
那么他的观点就是
，and his view is
新郎说的
，and spoken by the groom.
是玫瑰花。
So the groom is a rose.
我们说玫瑰花很普通。
It's very common.
整个沙伦充满玫瑰花。
The full of roses in the Sharon.
主耶稣他来到世界。
When Jesus came on earth,
他是 他是可让我们可以很容易亲近的一个人。
It's a person that we can easily draw near to.
他是谷中的百合花。
The lily of the valleys.
他是圣洁的。
He's holy.
他是奉献花。
He's a campfire blossom. 刚才我说
奉献花是什么呢
？What's a campfire?
就是表示主的爱。
The love of the Lord.
他是一位爱，他是位有爱的主。
He's a Lord of love.
所以我们看到。新郎他这么说了
，and therefore the groom said，
好了，新郎当新郎这么说的时候呢
，and when the groom said，
第二节
，verse two，
新郎就继续说了
，he continued，
我的骄傲在女子中，好像百合花在荆棘内
，as the lily among thorns， so is my love among the daughters。
哎，这里新郎就更，新郎就说：“我的骄傲在女子中，好像百合花在荆棘内。”
And the groom said that the lily, as a lily among thorns, is my love among the daughters.
我们刚才讲主是百合花。
Earlier on, we said that the Lord is a lily.
百合花是圣洁，也是尊贵。
It's both holy and dignified.
然后他救赎的教会呢
？And his redeemed church.
一样的，也是圣洁，也是尊贵。
Likewise, it's also both holy and dignified. And therefore,
我的骄傲在女子中，好像百合花在荆棘内。
As a lily among thorns, so is my love among the daughters.
意思就是说，他不但圣洁，他圣洁不但是比世人圣洁。
Not only is she more holy than the people of the world.
因为他的追求
，because of her pursuit，
他甚至比在教会中的众人，他都更圣洁。
That she is even more holy than the rest of the people in the church.
我的骄傲在女子中，好像百合花。
So my love among the daughters is like the lily.
当然，其他的女子也像百合花。
Of course, all the daughters are like lilies.
整个教会像百合花。
The whole church is like lilies.
不过我的骄傲，它特别的情况，它在荆棘内。
But my love, my beloved, is among the thorns.
就是。在不可荆棘本荆棘本来是不可生长任何好的植物的一个地方，因为被荆棘这个捆住了。
And so thorns is a place where you cannot have any good kind of things growing up because it will be suffocated.
但这位骄傲
，But this love,
它是百合花
，She is a lily.
其他的童女也是百合花。
The rest of the maidens are also lilies.
这个骄傲更加的在不可能生长的环境中，它生长起来。
But this lily in an environment is so hard to grow, yet she grew.
有种种的拦阻。
There are all kinds of difficulties.
有种种的批评。
有 all kinds of criticisms.
有种种的困难。
All kinds of problems.
但是它却长成圣他却长成了百合花。
But she became the lily.
他不可能圣洁的环境中，他圣洁了。
In a place where it cannot be holy, she is holy.
我想基督徒就是这样。
And I believe the Christians are like this.
我们活在一个怎么样的世界
？What kind of world are we living in?
充满了罪恶的世界。
It's a world full of sin.
你打开报纸
，You turn to the papers.
一切的罪恶都在我们的周围发生。
And all the things are happening around us.
很多事情在向我们招手
，and so many things are waving to us，
叫我们去犯罪
，calling us to sin。
过了一个年
，after the year，
你会不会感觉到诱惑很大
？You find that there are much temptations，
压力很大
，great are the pressures。
家里的这些迷信
，all the superstition at home。
家里的这些过年的坏的恶习
，and all the bad habits of the new year，
在向你招手
，are waving to you。
教牧人员去做探访工作的时候，就常常经历到这样。
So when the pastoral staff went to do visitation, they encountered this.
一家子基督徒
，a family of Christians,
祖孙三代
，and all from grandparents to grandchildren.
过年的时候
，during Chinese New Year,
就是聚在一起赌博了
，gathered together to gamble.
普通人吗
？Ordinary people?
不信主的人吗
？Unbelievers?
不是
，No.
信徒
，believers.
所以
，therefore，
环境真的很难让百合花生长。
At a time when the environment is hard for the lily to grow and survive，
我再说一次
，again，
在荆棘的环境中很难让百合花生长。
In a place where of environment like the thorns, hard for the lily to survive.
但主耶稣眼中的我的家偶在女子中，好像百合花在荆棘内。
In the eyes of Christ, that my beloved is like a lily among the thorns.
他圣洁。
He is holy.
不可能圣洁的环境中圣洁起来。
In an environment where he cannot be holy, yet she can be holy.
这是基督徒。
And this is a Christian.
今天一个基督徒在世界。
Today when a Christian is in the world.
在公司也好。
In the office.
在家庭也好。
At home.
在任何一个地方都好。
At any place.
在一群友人当中也好。
In a group of people.
很多时候是不能圣，很难叫我们圣洁起来的。
It's very hard for us to be holy then.
但是真正的神眼中的家偶。
But the love, the true love of the Lord,
在基督眼中的家偶
the true love in the eyes of the Lord,
在基督眼中的教会，在基督眼中的新娘
and the church, the bride in the eyes of the Lord,
是可以在不可能圣洁的环境中把圣洁彰显出来
and they can demonstrate the nature of holiness in an environment where it's so hard to be holy,
在不可能爱的环境中把爱彰显出来。
In an environment where you cannot develop love, yet you can demonstrate love.
然后接下来新娘又说话了。
And the bride continued to say.
三节
，verse three.
我的良人在男子中如同苹果树。我们读一起读二章三节。
Two three.
我的良人在男子中如同苹果树在树林中，我欢欢喜喜坐在他的荫下。尝他果子的滋味，觉得甘甜。我再一次说，我们是用这个基督跟教会的观点来解。
Again, we explain it from the perspective of Christ and the church.
所以我就觉得容易的多了。
So I find it's easy.
要不然这一段呢，也是非常的难解的。
Otherwise, very hard to explain this part. So we thank God.
我们用基督跟教会的观点。
So Christ and the church.
错误解经吗
？Is it a wrong kind of interpretation?
不
，No.
因为圣经自己说
Because the Bible itself says
夫妇的关系就是指着基督跟教会
The husband-wife relationship refers to Christ and the church
新娘说话就是教会说话了
When the bride speaks is what the church says
或是教会中的一位最有追求的人在说话了
Or maybe one of the one that pursues the most in the church
我的良人
My beloved
在男子中是如同苹果树在树林中
So my beloved among the sons is an apple tree among the trees of the wood Meaning
我的良人这位基督这位良人是无可比拟的
yes,
是没有办法可以比的
My beloved this Christ among all the people No one can be compared
对了无可比拟
Is that incomparable
他是无可比拟的
And so no one can hold a candle to him.
今天请问你如何看待基督
Today may I ask, how do you look at Christ?
你如何看待你的神
How do you look at your God?
他是众神当中的一位罢了
He's a one among all the gods.
很多人就这样
Some people say,
你信你的我信我的
You believe yours and I believe mine.
其实当我们这样讲的话
In so saying,
我们就把基督当作平常的一位
and we normalize Christ as one among others.
这位新娘说：“我的良人在男子中，如同苹果树在树林中，他是不可能。苹果树在树林中，他是出类拔萃，他是这一个无可比拟。”
And you thank the Lord because the bride says, as an apple tree among the trees of the wood, so is my beloved among the trees. So he is incomparable, one of the outstanding.
当你读出埃及记，摩西怎么说？
And so when you read this Exodus, what did Moses say?
耶和华众神之中，谁能像你？
Oh Lord, among the gods, who can be like you?
出埃及记十五章十一节。
And this Exodus 15:11.
谁能像你至圣至荣？
And who is just like you, the most glorious and holy?
可颂可畏。
And most worthy to be feared and praised.
施行奇事。
And who does wondrous things?
今天我们对我们的神的认识 是不是这样？
And is our knowledge of our Lord like this?
众神之中谁能像你？
And who is like you among the gods?
众神不是只有多神。
You're not talking about there are many gods.
众神其实就是说 在所有的人所拜的这些神明当中
that among all the deities and godlets that people worship,
哪位可以跟我们的神比
who therefore can be compared to our God?
他是至，这是最高点的
and he is the most
至圣
most glory, holy
至荣
most glorious
可颂
and fearful
可畏
and to praise
yeah, 他施行奇事
he does wonders
他是无可比拟的
and he is incomparable
良人如同苹果树
as an apple among the tree
虽然有许多称为神的就是许多的树
although there are a lot of trees there are a lot of so called godlets
只有这棵树
only this one
这棵苹果树是独特的
this one apple tree is unique
众神之中我们的神是至圣至荣
among all the gods our God is the most holy and most holy
我们的神是可颂可畏
and is very most to be feared and praised
我们的神是施情习事
and is God who does wonders
你这样看待我们的你这样认识我们的神吗
and do you know our God in such a way
我欢欢喜喜地坐在他的印下
and I sat down under his shadow with great delight
尝他果子的滋味
and his fruit was sweet to my taste
觉得甘甜
and it was very sweet
在神的印下
under the shadow
我欢欢喜喜坐在他的印下
I sat down with delight under his shadow
尝他果子的滋味
and taste his fruit
觉得甘甜
and was sweet
印下
shadow
有 上面是树我们坐在他的印下
there is a tree we are under the shadow
有树荫
the tree shadow
这是什么
this is
很容易解释的
Can explain easily.
这是护理
This is a providence
所以我们有神学的基础了
We have this basic theology
神学的基本神学的基础了
We have some this foundation basic theology
我们知道我们的神是护理的神
And we know therefore our God is a God of providence
在他的荫下得到遮得到遮盖
Under his shadow we receive coverings
这岂不是护理
This is a providence
尝他果子的滋味觉得甘甜
And that his fruit was Sweet to my taste.
有果子让我们可以享用。
We can enjoy the fruit.
这不是供应是什么
？If this not providence, what is this?
所以他护理。
So he watch over us.
他也供应。
He also provide for us.
所以你对神是不是这样的认识
？So do you have this understanding of God?
感谢上帝。
So we thank God.
因为我们这样的解雅歌。
Because we explain song of songs this way.
我们再次被提醒。
We are reminded.
我们再次被提醒。
We are again reminded.
我们得到神的护理。
We are under the providential care of God.
我们得到神的供应。
And His provision as well.
我们一点都不必自卑。
We don't have to feel inferior.
我们的神是众神之中谁能像他
that who can be our gods among the gods
他在他如同苹果树在树林中
and he's like the apple tree among all the trees
一枝独秀
and so just one unique
出类拔萃
and out of the ordinary
这就是我们的神
this is our God
好我盼望这样的解释可以帮助我们
and hope that this explanation can help us
最低限度让我们对神，神跟我们的关系会提升我们跟神的那一个生命的关系。
At least it can draw our life closer and higher to God.
我发现当我们这样解的时候呢
，And I discover when I explain such a way.
我们曾经在一些教会这么解了。
We explain this in some other churches.
我们得到的结果是什么
？And what is the result?
许多弟兄姐妹的生命得到提升
and the lives of many brothers and sisters have grown
我们有没有错误解经
do you explain in the wrong way
如果错误解经即使生命得到提升也不对因为这破坏了圣经的那一个真正的原来的意思
if it's a wrong interpretation and if your life is growing this is also not correct this is against the Bible
但是没有
but no
因为
because
夫妇的关系
husband wife relationship
是指做基督跟教会的关系。
It's referring to Christ and His church.
求主继续的帮助我们。
So may the Lord continue to help us.
我们祷告。
Let us pray.